Hey everyone, and welcome back to episode 35 of Fallout 4. Last episode, way over, actually, it's not really that far away, Abernathy Farms. So we turned in the locket that we found over at USAF Olivia, and that got us Abernathy Farms, like, instantly. Normally, you probably would have had to have discovered the place, received some kind of a quest, and then ran up there and took care of it. But instantly, they love us, so we have another settlement to work with. Obviously, I am still setting up supply lines. I do have a level right now. Maybe we could get local leader too, but I don't think I need it right now. I might hold off on the perk until I figure out what exactly I want to do. Now, there's two people down here at Starlight, which I'm betting we can take one of those people and like tell them to go to Ten Pines or tell them to go to Abernathy, which then links up all of those settlements. We'll link it up with Red Rocket. I do want to check one thing here really quick. So, there may or may not be a bug with leveling up Codsworth, his loyalty, basically just adding and pulling off accessory or like mods to your weapons. I think it's a glitch. You have to quick save. I'm not gonna do it, but apparently, just again, crafting things is what you want to do. Also, we made a whole bunch of adhesive last episode. That was pretty nice. I don't really think a full stock is needed on this thing. Tell you what, like the Stumptose pistol. Is there anything cool I can do? Oh my good god, we need Gun Nut 3 and 4. She is so loud. How much more damage? It's like 12 more damage. Oh my goodness, I want that. Why do we have dramatic music? Being like attacked? I mean, I get we're detected because there's NPCs here, but like... What was that dramatic... You hear that? Like... I don't know, man. You got me worried here. If we start getting attacked, then we know. But yeah, I can't really do the amazing thing. Wow, we use this crystal. Some of the better receivers. What about the barrel? Standard barrel. What's it do? Just increases range? I'm going to put the standard one on there. I probably would like to upgrade to the bull barrel. But again, we need to rank up Gun Nut. Standard grip, comfort grip, sure. I think we might upgrade this thing a little bit and have some fun with it. I don't think we need a scope on that or an optic of any sorts. It uses crystal. I don't know if we want to do that. Fuck it. We'll do it anyway. There we go. And did I get rats from that because it used nuclear material? It seems really weird that uses nuclear material. Stempus barrel. Let's get the regular barrel. So upgrade that. Codsworth again is loving it. And that just makes that thing that much better. Okay, so here's something we don't need to be carrying around. There's basically no reason to be carrying this musket versus this one, so we can take the accessories off of it if we had any on. I really don't think we do. Okay, so so we have the extended short barrel, improved range. So circuitry fiber. Oh, it uses fiber optics. I don't think I want to do that because those are apparently pretty beastly. But we should just start using this musket over the other one. That, for what it costs, resource-wise, yeah! Them procs, let's go with that. Again, they all use this fiber optics. I don't think I want to do any of that. I don't think I want to do that. The short stock, that's cheap to make. We've got the resources. Let's do it. Standard sights. Do I want to... I don't really think we need any kind of optic on this. I mean, maybe a short scope. What's it require? Absolutely nothing... resource intensive, so I'm going to do that, and we need to rename it. I'm terrible with names. We're gonna call it Zappy Zap because I am literally the stupidest person ever when it comes to coming up with names, and that just makes it so it's identifiable. That's the only reason I'm doing it. So do we even rename the right one? No, we didn't. So this is the one we're gonna end up scrapping. Let's rename this one. We're gonna call this Poop because we're getting rid of it. So let's just call it Zappy Zap because this thing turns things into literal ash. We've seen that before with the Deathclaw. Now, do I want to scrap it? I mean, I could pull some of the things off of it, but like, yeah, I'm just gonna scrap it. I am just gonna scrap Poop. Sorry, Poop. You're not worthy. So then, what we need? That's what I wanted to see. So we've worked our way up the progression ladder with his loyalty. So then we can start working on other NPCs. This is the main reason why I'm sticking with Codsworth for now. Let's favor that to 1. and the oh, I didn't quite name them right, did I? I gotta put the dash so then we know. We didn't name this one either. So if we favorite you, we'll put you on 6 so we can have access to you. Codsworth, you have to hold on, buddy. Let's rename it, and I just want to put in a dash. So basically that makes it take priority over all of the crappy weapons we just pick up throughout the world. Oh, I can't control A. At least you can shift. That's weird. So let's call this one. It's getting a dash. It's getting a dash. Cowboy, because I am dumb and I don't even care. At least I can identify it. Until someone else comes up with a cool name and I steal it from them.
Hey.
You're welcome to offer suggestions. I'm just going to go ahead and do that.
Hey, Codsworth.
Sir, perhaps now would be a good time to speak?
Of course. Go right ahead.
So gracious, sir. I do appreciate it. I've always had such admiration for you and your family, ever since the day my visual sensors were first switched on. You and the missus, so good with young Sean, and so trusting of me to look after such a newborn bundle of joy. It just warms my nuclear core. So, you can imagine the distress I felt when the bombs fell, after you fled to the vault. I searched, but found no evidence of your death. I could only hope you all made it in time. And when you returned, I was overjoyed. I admit I ran a full diagnostic scan just to make sure I wasn't malfunctioning. But the news of the missus and Sean, believe me when I say it takes a true hero to live through that.
You're pretty much a robot.
You think I'm a hero? I'm far from it.
Don't sell yourself short, sir. In such a bleak world as this, think of all you've witnessed and all you've done. In my 200 years, I've seen it tear good men and women apart. But you, sir, you have remained the very model of what humanity should aspire to be.
Thank you, Codsworth. That means a lot.
No thanks necessary, sir. I wouldn't hear of it. I truly believe if the Commonwealth is to turn itself around, you're the one to do it. Now, not another word. I stand firm in my belief. Let's get back to it.
Oh, we got it! I thought there was 3 tiers, but there it is. Having reached the highest level of affinity with Codsworth, you have gained the Robot Sympathy perk.
And, are you sure there isn't someone more...
And I think if I go to stats, I go to... What's under special? Nah, just perks, duh. So, Robot Sympathy. Next year, relationship with Codsworth, you receive plus 10 damage resistance against robot enemy weapons, energy weapons. So we have that much more resistance damage if we face robots using lasers, which I would think the vast majority of them do utilize. Do you have anything on you?
Sir?
Can I trade?
Right then.
Okay, so you can have your bowler hat. What we might end up doing now, it could also cause a problem. Can Codsworth be assigned to tasks? Let's learn here. I'm thinking we might steal Preston because his...
I've got something a bit different for you.
You have to hold on.
Scouts have found a promising spot for a new settlement.
Just
once you clear it out, set up a radio beacon to
just,
let settlers
just,
know.
You're just blabbing on, aren't
you? Before you know it, we'll have a thriving new farm instead of wasteland. We'll take back the Commonwealth, one piece at a time.
I think he says the same thing every time. But his perk you get is apparently really good.
I've heard that folks at Finch Farm need some help. The Minutemen should be the ones that answer that call.
Wow, we're just getting like all kinds of that. That's cool because this is putting things on my map.
Is there something you need?
Can I? Yeah, I should be able to call.
Come with me.
Bring with me.
I need your help.
Sure thing, General. I think the folks here can manage on their own now. Thanks to you.
So basically...
Sir, I'm sure you will take good care of my master. Good day to you both.
Take care, Codsworth.
So you can use him now as a follower, and same thing with Codsworth. I think he likes you being, you know, a good upstanding citizen and all that jazz. So as we liberate these settlements, I guess it makes sense to bring them with us. So I'm going to leave Codsworth here. Let's confirm the travel. Now, what I should be able to do, because we took Preston off of crops, I get maybe we can't. We might have to use or talk to other NPCs. I can still command him. I don't know if maybe we need to wait for him to quote-unquote reset. Maybe we need to take a nap. Let's try it. I want to see if we can command Codsworth in the way that we command other settlers. Because my crops then are going to be unattended. Let's sleep till it's next day so we can actually see what we're doing. And maybe we'll push out to some of these settlements. We'll have to look at the map to see where they are. Because I just want to start freeing places, liberating places, start gathering resources along the way. And we'll start setting up all these settlements to... Like, make, why did you sleep in the same bed as me? I don't even know you that yet. That well. Since I joined the Minutemen. Oh God. Oh God. This is getting dirty. All right. Preston's creeping me out. But Codsworth, I just want to see, out of curiosity, can I assign you to things? Because otherwise, we will lose a little bit of food, and in turn, I will lose a little bit of adhesive and such. I headed over that way, but I don't see him. Oh, there he is. He's in this house. Can I? No? No, okay. Looks like Codsworth... Spooky. Looks like we can't assign Codsworth the chores, which sucks. Everybody's on food, right? Yeah, you're on food. You're on food. I know you're on food. And you should still be on food, but I don't really recall. So we have 6, 12. We have 24 total food. Maybe I don't have everybody assigned to crops. Now let's just see, we had 23 food to begin with. See, I think she was assigned. Maybe we need to add another crop. I think I might need to add another crop. I think up to 23 this time. Let's just reassign everybody to the crops. Just to make sure everything's hunky-dory. Like anything that's missing somebody. So there we go, the count resets. Mama Murphy. We're back up to 22 again. Yeah, I think we have reached our capacity. Is there anything that is not assigned? Every now and then it gets really wonky where you can't look at certain crops. So I see like that one was able to be highlighted. I'm just going to go out on a limb and assume everybody's actually assigned to crops. So what I'm going to do is let's slap down one more. Because it looks like not everybody has a chore. What am I missing? Potatoes, we should have lots from other settlements. Corn and mute fruit. I'll put a corn down because I think we're... I'll put two down. We'll let them go. They should assign themselves if there's availability for it. If not, so be it. But we're going to get more settlers. We have the beacon. We have beds. So we have the capacity. In fact, I'm going to make another bed just to have one there. Maybe two. There's no harm in having more beds as we wait for settlers. So I guess while this was once a bathroom...
Oh God,
they're talking.
Do you want to talk about it?
No, I'm fine. I don't want to think about it anymore.
It's okay. I still think about him, too.
I said I'm fine. Leave me alone, June.
Poor June has to deal with that. She's like the worst. So there's two more. So we have a total of 10. And I think the amount of settlers you have is 10 plus your charisma. So I think we're at 6. So we should be able to have a maximum capacity of 16. Of course, that requires you to have the resources and such. But I'm going to add beds. Let the recruitment bacon do its thing over time. It should still be on. Yeah, it's green. So let's look at the minimap. Let's quick save just because. Let's see, where is Preston telling us to go? So that was one of them, Sunshine Tidings. There was some kind of a farm he mentioned. Oh, well, that's kind of out there. That one's not too far away. Well, let's go to data and then quests. Let's see which one, Overland Station, where is that one? Okay, so that one's a little far away for us right now. I think we'd be running into leveling issues. Let's go to this one. So that should now be my quest, right? Can I... Yeah, let's just make sure we have this one so it's the only thing showing up in the minimap so we don't get confused. Something stupid like that along the way. We will deposit all of the junk. Make sure I don't have anything else I don't need. I'll keep the flare gun for shits and giggles because I kind of want to try it. The long johns obviously don't require. Now, actually, what we can do is gear up Preston. So maybe when we're picking up crap from out there, off of these raiders and stuff, we'll probably encounter. We can gear up Preston. The dirty water, canned dog food, grilled red stag, all the stout, all those hub flowers, that weighs something. I mean, the mole rat chunks, the mole rat meat. We need to cook up the mole rats. So I'm just going to start using mole rat as my primary food. I got to just get rid of it. We have so much of it. Psycho jet, purified water, rad stag, meek, like all this stuff does weigh. quite a bit. Look at all those potatoes. So much weight in potatoes because we were crafting and harvesting them all. It's amazing how much of this I have. No, we're keeping our stim packs, clearly. Here are the mute fruit. Instamash, guan on a stick. Basically, get rid of this crap. Oh my god, look at all that. Look at that moonshine. Blood leaf, bubble gum. There we go. That gets rid of quite a bit of weight. Bloatfly meat. And the mods, because these are half a pound a piece. So there we go. That frees up a good bit. Now, I don't know if he has like a different weight capacity than, say, Codsworth. Somehow I bet that they're pretty much shared. So I'll leave it at that. There's dog meat. Do you know how long it's been since we've seen doge meat? I haven't been able to find doge meat in a while.
Mind if we swap some things around, dog meat?
Hey, buddy. I just want to, like, just... we glitch? Can I just check your inventory?
Hey!
Don't you do that. Creep me out, man.
Mind if we swap some things around, dog meat?
There we go. Okay, so he just got his bandana. All right, well, as long as dog meat's still, you know, alive, I'm happy. We haven't seen him in a while.
Hey. What do you need?
And there's his musket thingy. So, looks like all is well. Everyone's got all their items. Because Preston, you didn't see his gun in his inventory when we traded him earlier. Alright, so one should be this quick draw laser musket, so it's something about my AP recharging quicker. That was... Or what exactly did it do? Let's just get a handle on things. Cost 25% less action points. Not that that really matters on the laser musket. I mean, kind of. Not really. That's still a sign. That's still a sign. That's a sign. And then we should have the revolver. We only have 5 shots for this thing. I think we might be under-leveled, so we're not getting the ammo for it. Could probably pick up Scrounger. I mean, let's just look at our perks really quick here. I don't think we need to get Local Leader right now. Plus, we're not even at the level for it anyway. I might start specking in a Rifleman to get some extra damage. Maybe even Gunslinger, too. I bet Rifleman would be better. Sneak would be nice. Where's Scrounger? That would be really useful. More bottle caps and containers, all of which is useful. I might pick up Scrounger, but I know I need to start picking up some damage perks. Tell you what, let's get Rifleman. Let's get Rifleman. Just that much more damage. That's non-automatic, so obviously I don't want to be using automatics if I'm specking into this. You don't want to spec into too many things. It doesn't make sense. Let's see what the scope looks like. So this weapon... Oh, hello. This weapon would be really good against, like, most enemies for, like, sneak attacks and such, because I can charge it 3 times. And there's a bunch of mongrels or whatever. Where'd they go? Like, ran around the rocks. Did they all go back? They apparently all went back. Oh, I did hit him. So we almost killed him in one shot. That's pretty cool. Oh, wait, no, maybe I didn't hit him. It was the dogs. Come on, dogs, this way. Let's go. I don't know if this affects the laser thingy. I don't think it does. Let's actually test. Well, look at that damage. That was pretty respectable. You should be all but dead. Yeah, like I thought.
No point in leaving that for the scavengers.
You shut up, Preston. Used nobody yet. Ooh, you got quite a bit of ammo. And that's without Scrounger. So Scrounger should equal more ammunition over time. There's only just 2 mongrels. That one. That's the one I missed. All right. But yeah, we should get more ammo over time. Pretty cool. Might want to use some Rad-X. There's Abernathy. There was also, before we go to that settlement, there's like this big compound over here we wanted to hit up for sure. I think it's right there. Unless that's the billboard. Let's check the map. Was it like this way? Yeah, I think it's this way. There's this whole compound. We have no idea what it is. Let's check it out. Recruitment signal. Yep, right here it is. Recruitment signal lost. All right. Oh, there's Radstag. Blake Abernathy. Apparently I can see Blake, a.k.a. Chuck Norris, with Vats from here. Where's that Radstag at? Again. Like right here. I kind of want to shoot you in the ass because I'm a dick. All right. Let's. I mean, we get a face shot. Well, that's a butt shot. Really, sneak attack for that? Did that little? That little? All right, I'm gonna let it go because apparently we don't do shit to Radstags. Fuck you, Radstag. I give up on you. No idea how well Preston's gonna work out as a follower. Codsworth was kind of a tank because he was a melee character. Preston, obviously, he uses a gun, so I don't really think he's going to be tanking. And I think we're still in caution because of the rad stag. There's some ghouls. There's a scavenger. I just, like, talked to this dude. He didn't appear to be hostile. Keep the pipe rifle thing out here. Use the 38 ammo. And there's a feral ghoul over there. We'll hold off on it. Hopefully we don't, like... Okay. Are you a part of the settlement? Do we get new settlers? Like, what are you doing out here, buddy? You gonna, like...
Let's do this!
Okay, there's a blood fly. I'll help you.
All right.
Eh?
Still in one good scavenging and busted robots, if you know what you're doing. Amazing what people will just leave lying around like junk.
Huh? Are you just purely a random NPC that really does nothing? Where do those blood flies go? There's some rad barrels. Alright, I'm not gonna, like, kill the dude or anything, but... Okay, I guess that's all he does. I have no idea where those bloat flies went. Those corpses went flying. Not even gonna worry about just bloat fly meat. Anyway, there are definitely ghouls over here. Let's get a nice purchase up on this hill again. I thought he was, like, right there along the shoreline. I don't know. Hey, I could run back to the base if we get overwhelmed. No, I'm not gonna be able to see it, am I? Let's pull out the rifle. Let's sneak. It was, like, right over here where we could see it. Game's gonna be douche. Maybe he got up and moved. I don't know. There was a ghoul. There it is. Okay, so he's just laying there. I do not have a crit. He's level 3, so it shouldn't be too bad. Let's get a sneak attack on him. Looks like we downed him in one hit anyway. So we got extra damage. That's going to be nice. We were detected.
Hey, you must be with the Minute. I really appreciate everything you guys
yeah,
do.
Yeah, I only talk... Oh,
thanks.
Okay. She's looking
glad
at me, but
it.
Talking to him.
Keep up the good work. Here, take this.
Cool.
I hope you can find a use for it.
There's, like, interaction between them. That's actually pretty cool. I mean, like, we kind of already introduced ourselves as the Minutemen to her earlier. I mean, when we kind of gave them the locket.
Heads up.
Just point me to it.
Yeah, I want to check your inventory. Okay. I'm genuinely curious to see if she did give you something. It looks like she gave him a stim pack. That's cool. I wonder if he'll use it. That is cool. She just gave that dude a stim pack. Awesome. Preston. Damn, dude. You are a ladies' man. I'm thinking going up on this hill and getting a vantage point would be an excellent idea. Just try to avoid some extra rads. We are pretty radiated right now. Again, I'm still considering using a Rad-X. I don't remember looting that. We might have to hit that up, too. Nothing's detecting us, which is good. Alright. Nothing. There's just a random ghoul outside? Really? Quite a big lake. Look at that bridge. That's a dam. There's a whole big building over there. Dude. I bet before we go to the compound, hitting up this little shit shack would make more sense. I doubt there's really anything here. So, there might be, like, a rad roach or two, but... Let's kill it if it's here. I'm hearing kind of the sounds of maybe a rad roach or something. Alright, well, if there's nothing here, I will just investigate. There's always the mannequins. Always the mannequins. Oh, what was that? Ooh, that's a very well hidden first aid kit. Buff out, nothing in the toolbox. There's a broken ass toilet. Glowing fungus that I can't take. Yeah, I figured we'd hit this up because this is between, like, the radio towers and such. There's a lake on the mini-map right here. See, now we're getting distracted, which is fine. That's why I am playing no fast travel, so I can just walk everywhere and not feel bad about it. Where is this lake? Is that it? It's, like, right over this hill. It looks like a lake on the mini-map. Oh, the traders do. Okay, so your house doesn't show up as anything specific on the minimap, but the lake does. Alright, so now that makes more sense. So there's absolutely nothing between here and there. Obviously, it's a little bit different since we last explored it because it's day. But yeah, nice to know that there was nothing in this little shit shack. We really didn't miss anything. Let's push to the warehouse. Let's push to the warehouse and probably deal with ghouls. Usually where there's one, I find like 12. Rad stag. That I don't recall killing. But yeah, I mean, look over there. There's a whole big dam. There's some kind of towers, a satellite array. Maybe that's related to the USAF Olivia, how they had all those little satellite stations. I don't know. That seems cool. There is ammo or something in that bag on the roof, I'm betting. It's one of those little ammo bags. Is there a way to get up there? Let's work our way into the compound. Wicked Shipping Fleet Lockup. What the hell made that noise? Was that you? What are you doing, Preston? Okay, so we're detected. Alright, well, there's something here. Okay. I'm just waiting for like a ghoul to get up. That's always what happens. Alright, now we quick save. That's a ghoul. Alright, let's get outside, hop up on like a car or something. And pick him off as it comes towards me. Come on. I know you saw me. You got up. I ain't fooling anyone. Is he gonna be a jerk and make me like walk in there and then get back up? Did he sit back down? If he sat back down, I'll giggle. I will genuinely giggle. Oh, he's right there. He doesn't even know we're here. What the hell? So we triggered him, but then we got away? Alright. Alright, well, you're an actual dead dude. You're a skeleton. There ain't any hope of you getting back up. There is a radio on in the background. Preston, we're kind of looting right now. Get used to that. Just take all that. Ooh, duct tape. Adhesive. We shouldn't really need too much of that going forward, considering the whole farm thing. Oh, here we go.
Blake, I want you to listen to me as a brother here. This whole deal with Eddie is wicked shiesty. I mean, what kind of business partner threatens to kill you if the deal doesn't go his way? We are in way over our heads, man. I can't see a way out of this. No way except shutting down and getting out of Dodge. Give me a chance to talk this out with you.
Hear gunfire?
I just want both of us to get out of this.
Okay, so sounds like a business deal gone bad. Oh, hello. Oh, oh. That's a fucking super mutant, level 10. And I'm guessing this dude's dead. What? Hold on. What? What the hell? Okay, they're shooting something over there. These are level 10, so let's die. We'll quick save, but let's test it. I'm hidden. I don't have a guaranteed crit banked. Fuck me. Ruined that one. Apparently I ruined that one too.
Alright,
well, we can still hurt them a little bit, but they're going to hurt like a motherfucker when they get up here. Now remember, I'm getting some rifleman shots in. That's a Molly. I'm getting some rifleman shots in, so that's like my most damaging weapon. Let's go back through our escape route. Why is it like... I'm not sneaking, but it's not letting me run. How did the game get stuck like that? Alright, can I VATS anybody? Because I would like to build some crits. Can I position myself to do that? Yes, I can. Oh, they're throwing mollies back. They're throwing mollies back. Legendary slow time. Oh, I think that's my armor. Let's use our revolver. Alright, we're really hurt, clearly. I think we need to use a couple stim packs. To be fair, I said I would die here. Yeah, called it. So they're level 10, we're level 12, and we haven't specced in the damage, so that's going to happen. I did want to see what we could do. I bet we could take them, especially if you group them up like that. Let's not miss the first crit. That'll help.
Something's out there.
That'll help. I mean, the more I can do up front, the better. Like, if I can get them to just kind of derp like that more often than not. I don't know what that settler's doing. Like, if this is some troll gang and they all get along and... I don't know. They're playing, oh, look at me, I'm a human, and these super mutants are coming at me, bro. But they're actually on the same side. I don't know. Double agents! Put that guy's helmet off. So far, this is way better. And there's one down. Apparently that missed. I don't have that much 308 ammo left. Yes, Preston, we've got enemies. How about you go shoot them? He's almost dead. He's dead. There's one more, right? There's three. Where are you at? Where are you at, buddy? you're out there somewhere. Alright then. Oh. I don't know why he's running away. Not a clue. Preston's like very focused in this direction. Alright, so there's definitely one of these dudes left alive. But we don't know where he is. Okay, well, we'll quick save because we did kill 2 out of 3. Let's loot. See if we can find the last one. He poofed, man. Straight up poofed. Alright, so there's a piece of a super mutant. I don't recall killing him. Okay, so we've got 2 bodies. One's missing the head. That was that one. An automatic pipe rifle. Oh, we did get them all. Well, fuck me. I thought I only got 2 out of 3, but excellent. So that settler just kind of ran. That is Chemsbender. Maybe that's who they were shooting at. All right. Well, guys, I do have to wrap the episode up here. So this was episode 35. As much as I want to loot that building, we got distracted with random super mutants, and there's more gunfire. So we'll have to go see what the hell is going on. Either way, wrap it up here. Episode 35. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.